I just bought a brand new Tesla for $100. So not this Tesla, but this Tesla. See, I'm a little late to the party here, but I just put a deposit in on a Cybertruck. And when I went through that reservation process, it kind of got me thinking of the Tesla ordering process in general. How do you buy a Tesla the right way? What are the best ways to save money in the process? What options should you go for and what should you not go for? What are a waste of money? And what are the best ways to find some deals and discounts? So in this video, I thought I'd break down exactly what the ordering process is like, what options you should go for, answer some of the biggest questions, and show that you can, well, not buy a Tesla for $100, though you could reserve it for $100, but some good ways to save some good amount of money and get some steep deals in the process. So let's jump into it. So I've talked a lot about how Tesla is a very non-traditional automaker in a lot of ways, and this definitely goes to their ordering process as well. There is no Tesla dealership, though there are Tesla showrooms, and you can go there, you can learn about the car, you can sit in one, you can do a test drive, but when it comes to ordering one, you can do it at a store, but the person at the store is just gonna basically go through the same online portal that you'd go through at home. So test it out, do a test drive, get your hands on one and inside of one, and then when you're ready to order, you're gonna wanna go online at your own convenience and kind of go through the process on your own. There really is no reason to do it at the store. There is no kind of deal or discount. There's no negotiation at all with Tesla. The price you see on the website is the price you're going to pay. And that's just kind of how it works. Tesla is different for good ways and for bad ways. This is just one of those things that is non-negotiable. So I've got tons of videos on what to do before you buy a Tesla, things to consider, stuff like that. I'll leave some links down below and a couple up here as well. But for right now, let me kind of show you what the ordering process is like, some things to keep in mind, and kind of share my own experience, some of the biggest lessons that I've learned, and what I wish I kind of knew when I went back and was to order all over again. So when you go to the Tesla website, you have a couple of options here on things to order. Of course, you've got the S, the 3, the X, the Y. They're pushing solar. But for the purposes of this video, let's jump through the Model 3 configurator, though it's basically the same no matter which car you go for. The configurator is basically the same, just a couple of different options depending on the car you opt for. And you will notice here right off the bat, two options. You have a custom order and you have an existing inventory button. And I'm gonna do the custom order first, then come back to existing inventory, because the existing inventory is the place to go to get your car faster and sometimes cheaper. But first, let's go through the options so you know what you get, what's standard and what's not. So when you first look at this page, there's a couple of things to keep in mind. So you're going to see first a car preview on the side of the car you're configuring, and then kind of the big numbers to be aware of. With an EV, it's range. You've got 263 miles of range, the top speed, the 0 to 60 time. And then a couple of things on the right to be very conscious of. First, notice that you're right now in the include potential savings option. Tesla does this by mixing fuel savings and estimated just general savings on different categories in to give you the lowest possible list price, which looks great, but is not always 100% representative and really corresponding to the results you're going to get while you save, depending on your driving habits and stuff like that. So to keep things simple, I'm gonna switch over to purchase price because this is gonna keep things very simple, and this is just the straight purchase price of the car from the top, and then you can always subtract those savings that you'll get depending on your usage, your state, stuff like that. You can see here I'm in California, so I see that there's a $1,500 clean fuel reward that Tesla's showing me, but this is gonna vary state to state. And then you're gonna have kind of three options here. You can do a standard range plus, you can do a long range, or you can do a performance. Obviously the performance is the top end. It's gonna be the fastest, it's gonna be the sleekest, though it's not gonna give you the most range. It is gonna have dual motors. The long range is also gonna have dual motors. This is gonna give you the top current range of the Model 3 right now, which is 353 miles, 145 mile top speed, 0 to 60 time. And then you got the standard range plus, which is just one motor, and then kind of the shortest battery a range of the bunch, but is also the cheapest, coming in at under 40,000. This is 263 miles. Pretty good top speed, but also a slightly slower to 0 to 60 time than the long range. And then you'll also notice kind of two little options here. You'll see two differences here. There's a partial premium interior and there's a full premium interior. And you can tap on these and actually see the list of what Tesla tells you, the full differences, what you get with each. I'm gonna make things simple for you guys. I have actually have a video of the differences between partial premium and full premium. I'll link to up here, so I won't bore you with that in this video, but basically the big difference is it's fog lights. The big one is you're gonna get a much better sounding sound system in the full premium than the partial premium. Floor mats aren't in the partial premium, and some other small stuff. Rear heated seats is standard in the full premium, but not the partial premium. Nothing huge. The audio system is the biggest. That's gonna be reserved for the better cars. But if you want a full list, of course, check out that video for more information. So for this one, let's just say we're gonna go with the long range. We're gonna go with this $46,000, $47,000 long range, and we wanna continue configuring by hitting next. And then we have two options here. We have the color options and the wheels options. And Tesla used to have black be the base color that was free. And then when I got my standard range plus, I actually think I paid $1,000 or $1,500 for the white. They've now swapped that. Now black is a more premium color and white is free. So what you'll notice here is that white is free. It's included in the price. And then you have black, gray, and blue are all $1,000. So all $1,000 on top of the starting price tag of your model. And then if you want to go to red, that's going to be $2,000. And these colors are not dependent on your model. No matter if you get a standard range plus or a performance, these color prices are all the same. So $2,000 if you want red, $1,000 for anything but white, which is going to be free. So let's say for this case, we're going to save our money and go with white because it looks good anyways. And then your wheel options here, you have an 18-inch wheel, aero wheel, and then you have the sport wheels. You can kind of pick whichever one looks best for you. Those sport wheels are gonna be an extra $1,500. Let's just stick with the aero wheels for this one. Not too much of a difference here with interior because whatever level car you pick will kind of already give you the sound system and all the other appropriate features depending on the car you go with. So really your only option here is if you want a black interior or a white interior. White's gonna be $1,000. Tesla recommends this, but it's really personal preference whether you want black or white. Let's just stick with black for this. And then probably one of the most controversial things in the Tesla community is autopilot, whether you should buy autopilot or not buy autopilot. And to keep things very simple in this video, I have made several videos as of why I don't think in the latter part of 2020 autopilot is worth it in its current iteration. I'll leave a couple videos linked down below and up here. But if you do wanna buy full self-driving, it's $10,000. It's a $10,000 option, and to be clear and make this absolutely 100% clear, this is a option with the car. It's supposedly going to give you, of course, better features. It's supposed to give you, in a sense, better resale value, but it is tied with the car. It's not tied with your account. So if you drive this car off the lot and total it, full self-driving is gone. So just keep in mind that it is tied to the car and not the account, and it's the full $10,000 asking price and not broken up in any kind of monthly subscription fee. It is $10,000 rolled into a cash payment, a lease payment, or into a loan. So we're gonna skip that for this. And then we're gonna drop down to our final page here, which gives you a couple of different options here. So you can see the cash price of the car. This is $45,990. We can see what a lease payment would be. We can see what a loan payment would be. And then our $100 non-refundable fee. Now this is a non-refundable fee. This is not $100 that goes towards any part of the car. It's not gonna get refunded if you cancel. It's a non-refundable fee. And this is different because what Tesla used to do was just require a deposit, a down payment of $2,500 for your car. When I took delivery, I paid $2,500. That was a down payment for my car, but that was a down payment. That was a part of the payment for the car. That wasn't like nothing. That wasn't a fee. That was included in what I was already going to have to pay. In this case, you're putting a lot less money down, but you're not gonna get that money back if you happen to cancel, you return the car, whatever it happens to be. It is what it is. So there's pros and cons to both. Just keep in mind that that's kind of what you've gotten and there is no getting that money back. Something else you'll notice here is the estimated delivery timeframe of 2 to 3 weeks. Because remember, when you custom order this car, you are custom ordering it for your specific specifications. So whatever trim color you want inside, whatever the exterior color is, wheels, all that stuff is going to be custom made for you. But there are a couple of alternatives. In some cases, Tesla might have this car already built and configured and ready to go. In some cases, that's very likely and they'll just give you that car sooner. Or if you don't wanna wait, you can look and see what Tesla has in their existing inventory. So if we go back to the Tesla website and we go back to Model 3, remember that existing inventory button? Let's click that and let me kind of break down exactly what this means. So you'll see a couple of options on this page, your delivery zip code, how far you're looking to look, the kind of the search radius, the type of car, and then new or used. And you can also kind of dial this back here by the specific color, the trim level and all that stuff. But let me just kind of keep things general. So what existing inventory is, it's a collection of cars that Tesla already has that are ready to go and can probably be delivered in less than a week, if not around a week or 2 weeks. Typically, you can get these cars a lot faster than you would a brand new car rolling off the production line in Fremont, California. Typically, these cars can be test drive vehicles, they can be a showroom car. Usually, they've got some miles on them, but in a lot of ways, those miles, although not great, it's not brand new, it's new, considered new enough to sell, and also can be sold at a little bit of a discount. And you can, again, oftentimes get these cars a lot faster than a brand new car. So in this case, here's a long range Model 3. It's got about 840-ish miles on there. It's got the red exterior color. We know that's a $2,000 option. It also has the standard aero wheels. It does have full self-driving, which is a $10,000 option. And we can see that it has 322 miles of range and it has a $56,000 price. So you're saving a little bit of money by actually going with an inventory car. Here's another one. Let's scroll down here. Here is a long range. Is there a standard range? Here we go. Here's a standard range plus. This one has about the red color, which we also know is a $2,000 option. It's also got the upgraded wheels. So now we're at $3,500 of options. It's got the black interior, and this has about 1,100 miles on it actually, but it's a $39,000 price. So we know that that's actually a little bit of a savings because we know that there's options by themselves. We put this car around whatever number I have on screen. So you're saving a little bit of money if you opt to go with one of these inventory cars. So these are the new cars, but if you're looking to save even more money, you can also look at the used cars from Tesla. So if we go to used, we can see here's the standard range plus. It's 2019, so that's the year I have mine. It's got 240 miles of range. It's not the 263 you get these days, but 240 is good enough. But we'll notice that it has the black, the red color option, which is a $2,000 option. It's got the aero wheels, and it also has full self-driving. So if you were to configure this car today, that would be more like a 40 or 50-ish $1,000 car, depending on the options. It does have almost 14,400 miles on there, so it's not a brand new car, but you are saving a significant amount of money and also have full self-driving. There is a case that full self-driving might actually get your car a little bit more money. Let's look at some other ones on here. Here's about a 40,000 mile long range 2018 Model 3. It's got full self-driving, it's got the aero wheels, about 40,000 bucks. So you can kind of look here, depending on your location, where you are and kind of your delivery time frame. You can see kind of what some options are here with new or used cars. All these have warranties from Tesla. And again, these are going to get to you typically faster than a brand new car. And again, the new cars are not necessarily bad. They've just gotten some miles on them. And again, you can save a little bit of money if you go with one of these inventory or demo cars. So those are some options for buying your car and kind of what's gonna get you the car the fastest and what will kind of save you some money and get you the cheapest car in the long run. Okay, so I hope this video was helpful. That was kind of a little bit of a deep dive into the ordering process and some options. And kind of hopefully that helped explain the difference between inventory cars and used cars and new cars. Anyways, curious to hear what your guys' thoughts are. Do you have any tips for anyone ordering a new car, or if you're someone who's researching and looking into a Tesla, what is the best part or the worst part of the ordering process? Do you like that it's all done online? Do you like the whole non-negotiation process? Or do you wish you could drive down, pick up a car same day, negotiate and have it and drive it home? Let me know what you guys have to say about that. Thank you guys, as always, for watching. I'm Robert Rosenfeld, and I'll see you in the next one.